Louise Kugler felt healthy and fit when she found a lump in her breast 2 years ago.
One of the key things I was worried about with chemotherapy was losing my hair, because I've had long hair for pretty much all of my adult life and it's a key part of my identity.
But during her treatment, the Auckland mum was able to keep most of her hair because she wore a cold cap.
We're really just looking at protecting the scalp.
The cap works by cooling the scalp, narrowing blood vessels, which prevents the chemotherapy medicine reaching the hair follicles. Now the Breast Cancer Foundation plans to fund up to 10 scalp cooling systems for public hospitals, worth $50,000 each.
Women tell us it's almost more distressing to lose their hair sometimes than to lose a breast.
The technology's already in most UK hospitals and becoming widespread in Australia. Here it's available in some private clinics and in a Nelson Hospital unit following a Breast Cancer Foundation trial.
We've had one lady who said that she just felt that she wanted to be very private about her cancer, and keeping her hair enabled her to be able to do that.
None of the patients needed a wig. Hair loss ranged from 50% to as little as 10%. Some people experience headaches and feel chilly, but Louise says keeping her confidence made it worth it.
I think it helped my children go through the journey with me, and it was probably, I think, less traumatic for them because there wasn't a constant visual reminder.
DHBs around the country will have to apply to get a cold cap, an opportunity for some Kiwi cancer patients to have some control during a time of distress. Kate Nicol-Williams, One News.